If Jesus were alive, I think he'd really be tripping, seeing our most violent criminals calling themselves Christian. Or actually, maybe he wouldn't trip on none of it. After all, he was familiar with similar criminal governments. Just check the roots, it's one and the same noose. Electric chair to crucifix, now it's wolves in cheap suits. Just like the ones he knew, but real smooth, fighting wars while they pray to the Prince of Peace. Ooh, man, he'd be like, this wolf is new and improved. I know him well, I was crucified by Wolf and his crew. And they still got me crucified in front of their pews, while praising me as crazy ones, even named Wolfowitz too. What it do? Man, I wish it wasn't true, but this prophecy fulfilled, old voices coming through. The first shall be last, and the worst men rule, but the last shall be first, good cats will have to duel. Yeah. Christian, pull out your Bibles, get in study and position. Thou shalt not kill. Is there something that I'm missing? When every day you're killing, is this really your religion? Well, Jesus even took it one step further in Matthew 5, an eye for an eye will not justify murder. And beyond that, he said, love your enemies to strive towards heaven. But I didn't see you turn the other cheek on 9/11. In fact, I think you might have done the attack. But okay, let's say you didn't. You still responded by killing, all the while holding Bibles and saying it's Jesus' mission that you carry out. I highly doubt Jesus said to bomb children, but he did say check for leaders like you. Beware of false prophets and know them by their fruits. How about lies, wars, and countless dead troops? The last shall be first, I hope your savior spoke the truth.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Chapter 20, verse 8, it states that the fate of Satan's to deceive many nations and bring them all together in battle and devastation. It's too familiar, similarities are amazing. Iraq, Afghanistan, kidnapping a Haitian statesman who happened to be a former priest, if I'm not mistaken, and went to actually practice being the poor people's patron. Check Proverbs 14:31 for consultation. Oppress the poor and you insult the God who made them. Now let's ask the poor in Florida about their votes that weren't taken, or hurricane survivors, how much our government aids them. Then consider Leviticus says treat immigrants with veneration, and check our Christian president's current stance on immigration. Now it's more of an observation than it is an act of dissing, but according to your scripture it appears you're not Christian.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Said he was the first and the last.
Damn.
Now that flips the hourglass, or actually it breaks it. No side is taken, and maybe there is no top or bottom if we are awakened. So I pause for a second and put the first three verses of this song in question. Question: will the words I'm writing really lessen the violent oppression by calling out their deception? Or should I question my own involvement in the aggression, fighting fire with fire by spitting anger their direction?
Objection:
the truth should be known, that's no question.
Correction:
the truth may be deeper than we're expecting, cause we could turn the tables, but what would really change when as long as one's below, both remain in chains? And I know it's crazy pain, so how do we not retaliate?
What?
Maybe by knowing we're first in love and last when trapped in hate.